I am
behind the movement.
I'm just trying to hold on to a dream. Out here lost and nothing's what it seems. I'm just trying to find where I belong. This must be the dark before the dawn.
Hi, my name is Janae Moore, and I am behind the movement. I'm from Louisville, Kentucky, so I went to a studio there, and I did competition for 2 years. Then that was when I was getting tired of winning trophies because it wasn't getting me anywhere, but just winning trophies. So then me and my mom decided that we wanted to move down here so I could pursue my dancing career. And so she gave up her job, and my aunt, she moved down here, so we moved with her. And yeah, back in 2012, I think it was, and my uncle died of committing suicide. And so dance has helped me, and so I just dance for him, and I just think dance helps me heal my emotions. And
you dance with so much passion too.
Thank you.
My name is Quintrell Davis, and I am behind the movement. My freshman year in high school, I was in class, and some students was watching like Sean Bankhead videos on YouTube. So I didn't know of him or like nothing. So I was just like, where is this studio? Is it located here? And the following like week or so, the Dance Kids ATL premiered, and I was like, I want to be one of those kids. And so I like Googled it, and it said that they was having like kids company auditions on August the 12th. So I came, and the rest was history. My mom has 3 boys. I am the middle child. I have a younger brother and an older brother. My younger brother is 18, my older brother is 22. And my mom and my dad separated 6 or 7 years ago. We moved here from Thomasville, Georgia. So when I moved here, you know, it was kind of hard. Cause as soon as we moved here, my dad left my mom. So we was, you know, basically like trying to figure out everything. Well, she was trying to figure out everything by herself. And me and my mom was never like close. So it was hard because her and my brothers were very like close, and I was like the outcast of the family. Sorry. And so like it was like times where like she wouldn't feed me, and like if I got into like one of my younger brothers or anything, it was like times where they even like jumped on me, and you know, so that's.
My name is Christian Kelly, and I am behind the movement. Jeremy Green told me about Dance for 101 when he came to St. Louis and took class, and that's how I came to Dance for 101. My experience at Dance for 101. It's pretty lit. Cause like there's a lot more opportunities out here. I booked a tour out here. I booked commercials and all of that. So yeah, I really like it here. My big sister Jordan, she's not really in my life anymore. And I think that's that's really sad because she's my big sister and she just left. Like, she doesn't check up on me or anything anymore. It's just... My little sister, she's in St. Louis now. But I love her a lot. And I miss her so much. And my brother, I miss him so much. I haven't seen him in a long time. I haven't seen him since Christmas. My mom is in the hospital right now. She's having kidney problems and I just want everybody to pray for her. Cause it's really hard. It's really hard. That's all I have to say about my family.
Supports you a lot in your dance, right?
Yes, she supports me really well.
I am Bernard Bell, and I am Behind the Movement. How I found Dance 101 was I was a normal kid, not a normal kid, a track star, before I became a dancer, and I met Amari Jones, who's also part of our company team, and we became great friends in middle school. And I remember on her birthday, we came and took a class, and it was BJ's class, and he had his brother, I think, assist him for his birthday, and we took class. And after that day, I really found myself loving dancing, and I was like, I really want to dance at the studio, you know? And my mom was like, you should come, Bernard, because I know you're better than that, and I know you're a great dancer, you know? And I was like, why not? And my mom wasn't arguing about it. She felt like I should do something that's going to challenge me. And that's when I was like, okay, I'll come to Dance 101. And that's how I found it. And I felt like my family didn't support me, you know? Like, they didn't want me to dance at all. Like, I'll be like, oh, I want to dance. They'll be like, no, boy, play football, play basketball, keep running track. And they'll tell me how great I am to persuade me to play sports instead of dance. And when I moved to Georgia at the age of 11, I played football and I became a track star and I went into the Junior Olympics. And that happened, but that's when I also got the mindset that I should put my foot down and whatever I want my future to be, I'm going to make it happen. And I shouldn't let my family members tell me that they don't believe in me and stuff. And Jeremy knows, like, Jeremy even saved me. Jeremy saved me from Jeremy just saved me from I wanted to commit suicide because I felt like I wasn't important and I felt like my mom didn't care, you know, because I had sisters. And I feel like they were more important, you know, because they had a lot going on for themselves. And I used to be the stay-home body, you know? And when Jeremy came into my life, like, I first thought me and Jeremy was never gonna kick it off. But Jeremy actually saved me, you know? Jeremy knows about my father's situation, and Jeremy saves me. And he's like, keep your head up, man. Like, you don't have to be down because of how your father feels and this and that. And Jeremy makes me feel like I have a purpose of being here, you know? And like, everybody has a happiness, you know? Everybody, not only dance is my happiness, but also being with Jeremy is my happiness because Jeremy makes me remember that I am important to this world and I do have something to live for and I can accomplish what I want to accomplish.
Always believe in yourself, because if you never believe in yourself, you won't be able to make it through most of the things or like difficulties, because if you don't believe in yourself, then how are you gonna, like, you're not gonna be able to achieve a lot of things, because if you can't believe yourself, then you can't push yourself to do more things. You should help me support my dreams because I really love to dance, and it makes me I use dance to express my feelings, and I just think dancing makes me feel good, and without dancing, I wouldn't be able to be happy today like I am.
Dance makes me release all my emotions on the floor, especially when I'm like really mad or upset or sad about something. It just helps me. I come here almost every single day just to help me release my emotions. And I think I love dancing so much. It's my passion.
I feel like people should support me and my dances because I don't just look at this as a joke. I really love what I do and I really want to perfect my craft, and I feel like I can really go far with this in my life. And you know, I'm not someone who wastes time. I'm someone who takes information, takes notes, takes the step, and not only just takes the step, but give it back. Not just give it back, I can go really far with this, and I take this very seriously. And I know I can go really far, and I know I'm gonna be something with dance, you know? And I can just give back in a positive way.
Well, dance, number one, is it has like taught me a lot of confidence. So I feel better about myself now. I can say that. And I know, like, if I'm having a bad day, I know that I can dance the pain out. And I know it might sound crazy, like dancing the pain out, but it's literally some days I can come take class and I'll be okay. Whatever I might be going through that day, I can take a class, an hour long class, and I'll be okay when I leave. So dance has helped me, and dance, basically, I can say has saved my life.